Hello friends, welcome to today's SPAR session. In this session, we will see a scenario based interview question on Spark. And the question is, we have a data frame called in_df. And we need to calculate the record count for each partition inside that data frame. This question will also help us in investigating the data skewness. So as a first step in data skew, we need to find which partition has how many number of records, so to ensure whether the data skew is available or not. So to that, this question will help. That being said, let us get started with our demo. As usual, we have logged into our Databricks community edition and also started the cluster as well. For this demo, we are taking the data set of bankchunkers.csv. This data set can be downloaded from the kaggle.com. I will give a link in the description of a data set. You can go ahead and download it for our demo. So that being said, let us run the command to which is defining a path. Here in our Databricks, the new option has been included for us to upload the data. If you go to this file menu and click, you can see upload data, from which we can go ahead and browse directly from the local path. We can select the data set and then we can load it easily into our workspace that we need. So I have loaded it like that. And then the third command, let us run it. It is to read the CSV file. I have given a header as true as well. So let me read the data file and let me display some results for us. It is taking a bit time. Actually, this data set has around 10,000 records. So I hope since it is a local system, it is taking some time. We can see like there is some a number of rows and columns which is being populated here. And let us note this column alone, card category, which has some column names as blue, gold, silver, and some color names it will have. So let us see that alone for now. And then the count of the data frame is 10,127. The data, since it is in a local, it is having a single partition. So for understanding our concept, I am making it as a partition of 4. I am making it as a repartition of 4. So let us check the number of partition now. So we can see like it is having a number of partition as 4. In our Spark, we have a function called Spark partition ID, which can be used here to get the number of partitions, I mean number of records in each partitions. So how we will do that? I am importing this function first, and then I am adding a with column in which I am adding a partition ID as a column name, and I am using this function. So this will give us the partition ID for each partitions, and then I am adding a group by in which we are having a group by of this partition ID and getting the count for each partition. Let me run this and I am displaying the count. So here you can see the partition, I mean the count is evenly distributed. It is having a 2532 or else 2531 count in each partition. We have 4 partitions and it is evenly distributed. Now let us see the skew data. Now instead of giving it as 4, I am using a column name called card category, in which we have a color details. I mean like say I have a scenario for each cards I have to offer a deal. So I need to join it with the card category column. So I have repartitioned the data based on the card category now. It completed. Let us check the number of partitions again. So here you can find it shows 200, but the thing is like we will have only data in a 4 partitions. Let me run this again and this as well. So here you can find We have four partitions, data in a four partition, but whereas the count is being different in each and every partitions. And obviously you can find the third partition is having more data. Around of 10,000 records, around 9,400 record is only in one partition. So if we are using this for our join conditions, then it might lead to a skewed dataness. Here in Databricks, we can also give a bar chart and check this. So if I click this graph button, you can see like this has been given in a chart. So by this option as well, we can say there is a skewness in data easily. This video is for understanding and investigating whether we have a skewness in our data. We will have a separate video on how to resolve these things in further. That being said, that's it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Give a thumbs up signal to this video if you like my content, and also subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.